Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So today we're going to be talking about everything hair growth. I just want to give Hair Stimulator a huge shout out for partnering with me to bring you guys today's video. And before we get started, I just want to make sure you guys smash the like button, comment down below, and you know, make sure you subscribe to my channel and have my post notifications turned on. So hair growth. You guys have seen me post various videos in regards to hair growth, and a lot of people, especially when they're first beginning the journey, they think hair growth is just something that just happens overnight. You know, they think it's just, you know, one, two, bam, I should see inches. You feel me? When it doesn't work that way. And a lot of times hair growth is really dependent on what you do and just your normal routine. And I'll kind of explain what I mean more so towards the end of the video. But let me just go ahead and get into the tips that I have for you guys. Okay, so this could be like number one and two, but finding a moisturizing shampoo. Now I know you're like, how is that gonna help with hair growth? But hear me out. Most shampoos are gonna somewhat strip your hair. They're gonna cleanse your hair. Your hair is gonna be left feeling a little stripped, even if it doesn't have sulfates. You wanna find a shampoo that's basically is like a happy medium of moisturizing and cleanses. On a week-to-week basis, you don't want something that's going to overly cleanse your hair. You need the sebum that your scalp naturally produces. You need that to basically marinate in your scalp to see healthy hair growth. Now, shampoo that I'd recommend, of course, is the Hair Stimulator Hair Growth Shampoo. You guys have seen me use this before. You know, I've raved about this line for well over a year now, and I still use it very consistently. It's a shampoo that it obviously cleanses, but it's not going to leave your hair too stripped unless you just go overboard and you just slap too much on your hair. Another thing I want to mention is when you're using a shampoo, make sure you use the coordinating conditioner with it. I'm going in with the Hair Stimulator Hair Growth Conditioner, and the reason why is because these shampoos and conditioners, they're formulated to work best together, so that's how you're going to get maximum results. Making sure your shampoos and your conditioners contain 1 to 3 primary hair growth oils, like a Jamaican black castor oil or something like that. The shampoo conditioner that I just told you about, it contains Jamaican black castor oil, so we're good. It contains Jamaican black castor oil, Regenerex, both of those are vital for hair growth. And then of course for your conditioner, basically a conditioner is easy. Make sure it doesn't have silicone, make sure it has slip and is moisturizing. That's really all three things that you need in a conditioner. All right, so next up, hair supplements. Some people think this is kind of controversial. Some people don't believe in hair supplements. Some people don't believe they actually work. I was one of those people. Now, to a degree, I still kind of stand by what I say. And what I mean by that is hair growth supplements are not gonna work if you're only using them for a month or two. You feel me? Hair supplements is something that you have to constantly use. It's like a commitment. You have to use it, I feel like, for at least a minimum of 3 to 6 months to see promising results. Because a supplement is basically like a multivitamin. It's basically giving your body nutrients to accelerate the hair growth process, right? And your body is really only going to keep what it needs. Everything else is just gonna filter it out, so you're gonna piss out everything else. That's just if you're going overboard. If you're really looking to make that commitment, it does not hurt to take hair supplements. I do like to take the Hair Stimulator Hair Growth Pills. You guys have heard me talk about this for well over a year. The whole Hair Stimulator line I've been using for well over a year, and you guys have seen it in the past. I've seen it. They do work. And it's not that I've been going overboard. Literally all I do is I just eat like I normally would. At the end of the day, I take 2 pills. That's it. Using protein and keratin to help strengthen your hair. This isn't going to promote hair growth. So I know some of y'all are probably like, okay, well, why is this in the video? Your hair is made out of protein, right? Protein and disulfolate bonds is basically the backbone of your hair. Simple wear and tear, putting your hair up in a ponytail, washing it, being aggressive when you detangle it, using heat, using chemicals, bleaching it, what I've done in the past, things like that, that's gonna alter those bonds. That's gonna weaken the protein in your hair. So that's why you use protein and keratin to pack back on those protein molecules. So when it comes to rebuilding bonds, I do like to use the Olaplex Hair Perfector. Now, this has been on the market for a while. I'm not gonna lie, I haven't had this for long just because when I was getting bond builders put in my hair, I was having it done professionally. And it's a treatment that you have to consistently use, otherwise it's going to essentially wear off. And the same thing goes for protein treatments. Now, protein treatments, that's something that is much more accessible to basically anybody. You can get expensive protein treatments, you can get cheap protein treatments. Most protein treatments are safe as long as you're not overusing them. So as long as you're getting some type of protein, keratin, or even bond builders, as long as you're putting that in your hair just every once in a while, you're good. What that is gonna do is gonna minimize breakage. So you're not ripping out your hair, you're retaining your hair growth. Okay, next up is using oils. Now there are so many oils. I'm pretty sure there's like hundreds of oils. Now using oils is something that I wasn't really fond of until I started getting back into coloring my hair. And the reason why is because I just felt like oils were excessive. I felt like they just coated my hair. But you have to know how to use oils. You have to use them the right way. So what I like to use is the hair stimulator, follicle stimulator, which contains multiple very beneficial oils. You know, it regenerates your hairline or thinning edges. It contains Jamaican black castor oil, a botanical blend, vitamin E oil, jojoba oil, just a lot of great oils. And I love jojoba oil just as equally as much as I do Jamaican black castor oil. I do like to use a follicle stimulator after my hair has been washed, or when I'm like refreshing my hair and my scalp just feels like a little dry, you feel me? All right, so this is a short and sweet one. Finding the right deep conditioner. Now, there are hundreds of deep conditioners, and I will kind of touch base on what my favorite deep conditioner is in an upcoming video. But basically, the way to finding the right deep conditioner for you is it basically leaves your hair really soft and easily manageable. So usually the steps that you take in your wash day is you shampoo and condition your hair, you apply a deep conditioner, then afterwards you style your hair. So in that styling process, after your deep conditioner has been rinsed off, if your hair is easily manageable, it's really soft, there are no tangles, that's how you know that deep conditioner did the job. All right, so lastly, this is my last step, self-evaluate, being honest with you. So if there's always a consistent problem in your hair routine, so like if your hair is always dry after day two hair, use more moisturizing styling products. If your hair is always overstripped and just dried out after shampooing, use a different shampoo. If there are things in your routine that really frustrate you or is just a hindrance, kind of take a step back and think, why? What is it that I can do to change that? And here's the reason why. You want to find a routine and stick with it. Once you stick with that routine, the hair growth will come, because there's nothing that's just going to get you 3 inches in a week. You feel me? Being consistent with your hair, just making sure it's in its healthiest state, taking supplements if need. Basically, doing more with less, that's all you can do, unless genetics play a factor. See, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope these tips were helpful. But yeah, if you guys enjoyed this video, then don't forget to give me a big thumbs up. Do not forget to click the link to check out Hairstyle Stimulator. I will probably have a discount code either somewhere on the screen or in the DB. I'll have all the information pertaining to Hair Stimulator down in the DB for you guys. So yeah, I just want to thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys in my next video.